I'm going to be covering a training program called Is My Resident Well? This program has been designed for care homes and has been rolled out all across Northwest London. And it aims to help care home workers ask two questions. Firstly, how do I know if my resident is becoming unwell? And secondly, what can I do about this? We're going to be looking this morning at how we can assess this step by step in an easy guide. So we all know when we can tell that somebody's not quite right, but sometimes it's harder to put our instinct into words. The original name for this training was Recognising and Acting on Signs of Deterioration, and deterioration is one of the key concepts that we need to understand. When you work with somebody every day, you get to know them really well, and we sometimes call this someone's baseline function, how they normally interact with you, how they normally communicate, what they're normally like, how they normally mobilise or move around. If there are some small changes in these things, then these can be early signs that something isn't right, and this is the time when we need to try and act to put things in place to stop it getting worse. If changes happen over seconds or hours, for example, something like chest pain, which could be a sign of a heart attack, then this is something that needs urgent attention, for example, calling 999, and this would be a red sign. However, some changes can happen much more slowly, over days or even weeks, and they can be harder to spot if someone is slowly becoming more unwell. And this might be amber signs like becoming more dehydrated or becoming constipated. If we look at this chart, we can see that over the course of time, somebody can sometimes enter what we call the slippery slope. Now, this might start off somebody at their normal function or baseline, and then as time goes on, you notice that there's something that's different to usual. Now, this might be the time that you think they might need a clinical review. For example, you might feel that you need to get your senior to come and review them. Or perhaps you need to call out the GP, and that could wait for the next day. However, if something becomes more urgent and someone's becoming more unwell over the course of the day, then you might need a more rapid response. And things that you can do for this would be to use the community independent service, which we're going to talk more about at the end. Or perhaps you could ring 111 and ask for an urgent visit. Sometimes your resident might become so unwell or the changes happen so quickly that they definitely need a hospital admission. And of course, you're always free to call 999 if this is the case. So the other key concept for us to understand is frailty. Most people would understand what we mean by somebody being frail, and this is particularly relevant for anybody who's in a care home, who is by definition unable to care for themselves in the same way they were before. Frailty can incorporate many things like mobility, how somebody's able to move around. It might be related to their cognition or their confusion or dementia. Frailty is basically the idea that somebody's lacking in the resources that they need to cope with the normal stresses of life. Something like a urine infection wouldn't have too much impact on an ordinary healthy adult, but for somebody who's frail, it can be the difference between becoming completely bedbound or completely functionless. And this is why the kinds of residents that we're looking after from the beginning are much more vulnerable to any stressor that happens, including ill health and illness. And this is why we need to take extra care with looking out for some of those subtle changes that can happen to our frail population. So this graph shows the life course with different illnesses. As you can see, somebody who has cancer often will continue at their usual level of function over quite a long period of time. And if the cancer sadly becomes untreatable and takes over their body, then there's a fairly short period of time in which they deteriorate to the point that they pass away. For somebody who has organ failure, so for example, somebody whose heart doesn't work properly, or perhaps it's their kidneys that keep failing, they can have sudden worsenings of their illness. And this causes a decline in their function, but they usually bounce back a little bit and return to some kind of function again. However, as time goes on, this gets less and less. And you never can know which of the sudden worsenings is going to be the end point for them. However, the most unpredictable illness of all is frailty. And that's because people who are frail, their function often just slowly deteriorates over a longer period of time, perhaps months or years. And so it's hard to see difference from one day to the next. But overall, they can just get worse and worse. And so for frail people, they can sometimes pass away without what seems any warning, other than if you look back and see that they've been getting worse over time. In terms of knowing how quickly we need to act, sometimes a traffic light system can be helpful. If you remember the baseline, so somebody's normal function, then this would usually coordinate with a green, where you just carry on with your routine care as normal. If someone's showing some small signs of change that maybe are happening over days or weeks, then these could be the amber signs that need attention, but there's not so much urgency. And then finally, the red signs would be the things that you don't have very much time before someone might become seriously unwell. So anyone who's having a real difficulty with their breathing, for example, the right thing would usually be just to call 999.